We reached the third Advent and it is time for another Bible verse forecasting the Advent of Christ. This time it is Isaiah 46:13. I bring near my righteousness, it shall not be far off, and my salvation shall not delay, and I will place salvation in Zion, for Israel my glory. Nice. This time the demo is from another year than the reviewed game. Enjoy the Xerox BBS Christmas demo from 1991. You can find a download link in the video description. We'll be right back. Today's game is number 3 in my favorite DOS games list. Turrican 2 by Rainbow Arts from 1995. It is a game I never completely beaten. So let's see how far I get without cheating this time. But first, something about the company behind it. Rainbow Arts was a German game publisher, infamous for some games that were obviously inspired by other games. The first game that comes in mind is the great Gianna Sisters for the C64 and the Amiga. It is a Super Mario Bros. Clone that had slightly different game mechanics as the original. Some of its levels were exact copies of the original. First, this did not bother Nintendo, but when Rainbow Arts advertised the game with the slogan "The Brothers are history," Nintendo took actions against it, and the game vanished from the store shelves. Aside from the great soundtrack, the game was mediocre, but it got great sequels with Gianna Sisters Twisted Dreams and Rise of the Owlwarlord. The second game that led to legal disputes was Katakis. The C64 version was obviously inspired by R-Type, but it had unique levels and bosses. Gaming magazines rated it as a R-Type clone that is much better than the original. But in contrast to this, the Amiga version was a blatant rip-off of the original R-Type and copied the complete levels while only changing some of the graphics. This led to legal disputes, and an arrangement was made that Rainbow Arts had to program the C64 port of R-Type and could continue to sell Katakis. Regarding taking inspiration from other games, the Turrican series is not very different from Katakis for the C64. The Turrican series is highly inspired by Metroid and the arcade machine Psychonix Oscar. Therefore, some call it Metroid for the C64. But this does not do the game justice. The Turrican series has its own style and its unique experience. Turrican 2 is the only part of the series that is ported to the PC, and it is an awesome game. It is a run-and-gun platformer where you have to explore huge levels and are confronted by huge bosses. The graphics in the PC version are polished and the bosses are redesigned, but although they fit perfectly into the levels, they miss the cartoony style of the Amiga or the C64 version. There is only one cartoony element left, which you will also see in the game's intro. When you jump on a walker, it gets squished and runs away. The sound and music of the PC version are awesome. I highly recommend using a digital joystick for the control. A rapid fire switch on the joystick is also helpful. You won't enjoy the game if you try to control it with a keyboard or a gamepad. You have to push the stick up to jump. In the game, you will collect weapon upgrades by shooting on hidden blocks. Your primary weapon will switch between laser, multiple, and bounce, depending on which weapon you collected last. It will be activated by pressing the first fire button shortly. The laser is a most powerful weapon. The multiple has only medium power, but since it is a spread shot, it is very useful in some levels. The bounce is the weakest weapon. Most time it is as if you shoot cotton balls on your enemies. But since the bounce splits every time it hits a wall, it can be very effective in narrow, winding passages. By pressing the first button permanently, you will activate the surround shot, also called the trail, which you can rotate in any direction you want. All weapons can be upgraded in 4 levels. By pressing the second fire button, you will activate a power line, which fires 2 shockwaves in opposite directions. You can only have 3 power lines at once, so this weapon is limited. You can also activate a super weapon by pressing both fire buttons at once. By pressing down and the second fire button, you will turn into gyroscope form anytime you want. In this form, you will be invulnerable to enemies and their weapons. After exploring the first level, level 1-1, a few minutes, you will encounter the first boss called Rob Ott. It will be easy to take him out with the laser and the trail. The bosses are not always stationed at the end of a level, and there is still much to explore in this level after beating the boss. There is a time limit for each level, and it is normal to die once in a level by a timeout. This is no problem because there are enough extra lives to collect. Power up. The PC port is based on the Amiga version. This port contains less secrets and has easier bosses than the C64 version. And the last level, level 5-2, is completely different. The PC version also doesn't show the level numbers at the beginning of each level. A speciality of the Turrican series is that you are not invulnerable after getting hit. Therefore, even enemies that do low damage could drain your energy if you do not take care. You can always pause the game if you want to. In the middle of level 1-2, you will encounter the boss Starship, who will give you 2 extra lives if you beat him. This is one of the bosses which can be missed if you take the wrong route. And at the end of level 1-2, you will encounter the next boss, Scarface. Time for the super weapon. In level 2-1 you will have a long underwater section with squids, catfish and robot submarines and of course big fish. At the end of the level there is periscope and my weapon is at low charge after I died again due to time out. So it is time for the trail. Wait, that's all? I remember this boss different. Let's just switch to the C64 version. Well, that's more aggressive. Back to PC and level 2-2. Now it is time for the trail. These spike balls can be really dangerous. It is the enemy version of the bounce. Very low damage rate, but as it splits up into smaller parts, the combined damage gets lethal. Oh baby, baby, I'm out of time. Just before I had to beat Jack the Gripper, I lost a life. From level 3-1 to 3-3, the game will change into a side-scrolling shooter. And don't let the game switch your weapon to bounce in front of the boss. Well, now it will take some time to beat Walleye with cotton balls. shot you. This time you could not switch my weapon to useless junk. Unfortunately, Turrican 1 and 3 were cancelled on the PC, so he is not back. But now it's time for Laser Larry. Time for level 3-3. But what happened to my brakes? Luckily, I collected Phaser and not Bounce before I had to face Mech Clash. And help for my ship is on its way. But where are all my extra lives gone? Level 4-1 is huge, and the best weapons for it are Multiple and Trail. If you do not find the shortcut to the end of the level, you will face Fumo Bad Press the Dragon. It is the end of level 4-2 and I got one extra life left. So let me introduce you to the Arnie Walker. More tanks than Walker. And here is a situation where the game actually helps you. If you die, the game will deactivate all enemies in the section where you died. This means I can continue to level 5-1. Welcome to the Aliens level. No Turrican game is complete without it. Beware of acid dropping eggs on the ceiling, facehuggers and these alien doggy thingies. And the game gives me Bounce, which is bad, and Trail, which is good. I highly recommend switching to gyroscope form whenever possible. Getting hugged by a facehugger will mean instant death unless you quickly activate the super weapon, which you can only do once per life. Of course, I lost my last life and had to restart the game with a built-in cheat code to show you the end of the game. No loss of lives, no downgrading of weapons, unlimited power line, but also no score. In the C64 version of the game, you will ascend to the top of level 5-2 with a jetpack. Here you will have a set of elevators where you have to do some perfectly timed jumps to get to higher levels and finally reach the top. And there you will finally fight the machine. Unfortunately, the game is not available on GOG or Steam, and the Turrican Flashback Collection has not been ported to the PC. So if you want a legal copy, you have to get one on the second-hand market. Just check it is a correct version, since the game was released on different platforms. As always, some people request insane prices for this game on eBay. Ignore them. It is still possible to get it for a reasonable price. Now enjoy the end scene and the credits.